As the number of microservices deployed across private and public networks increases, security becomes a very important topic discussed among developers. Leveraging a service mesh guarantees security of application and services without burdening developers to build security, freeing them to focus on business logic. And for our organization, it allows them to meet and prove their compliance and security requirements. In this demonstration, you will learn how Kong Mesh enabled zero trust security for applications and services. It achieved by enforcing mutual TLS communication, applying traffic permissions to control which services can communicate to one another, and natively integrating with OPA Policy agent to enforce fine-grained authorization. Let's get to it. When we talk about zero trust security, what essentially we mean is that we're not gonna trust to any service that runs in the same network. With zero trust security mindset, just being on the same network with the services would be not enough. Let's break down this our current example. We have a microservices deployed inside our Kubernetes cluster, and we have a Kong ingress that allows communication to those microservices from outside world. We see here there's a blog engine that communicates with Apollo GraphQL server. Blog engine contains and stores information in database and also communicates with another service that provides natural language processing services. We have this deployed in Kubernetes as a multiple different deployments and pods, what we can see here. And we have all this deployment as a part of a mesh. And our mesh doesn't have any policies applied right now. And nothing holds back to services to communicate to one another. Like everything works, we can submit mutation requests, we can create posts, etc. One of the things that you can notice here is that we do have this arbitrary PSSQL client that somehow slipped into our installation. Maybe it was a part of our previous deployment script when we need to test our database connectivity, but it can be create some additional issues in production that someone can log into production database and do things without our permissions. And it has a connection to our production database. And this is exactly what we don't want. As we can see here, our PSSQL client is on the same network, but it is not desirable to have it in our production environment. Let's do something about this. So first thing that we're gonna do is establish mutual TLS communication. By implementing mTLS, we're not enabling zero trust per se. But what it allows us to do in future allows us to establish very fine-grained traffic permissions, and we can be more explicit about what service can communicate to what service. In order to set up mTLS, we need to create this mTLS spec inside our mesh definition. And in this particular case, we're gonna be using a built-in certificate authority. We can go ahead and apply this policy. And now when we can see this inside the Kong Mesh UI, we see that mTLS uses built-in certificate authority and application still works, which is nice. But our PSSQL client still working here. And the reason for that, why it is happening, is that because this PSSQL client is also part of the mesh. And we established this mTLS connection for this random PSSQL client. Now, let us be a little bit more explicit about the policies, which service can talk to which service. Let's take a look what kind of traffic permissions we already have. So in this particular case, we're going back to Kong Mesh GUI and go into traffic permissions. By default, we do have a allow all policies. As you can see, there's source and destinations take the wildcard as a name of the service. This means that every service in our service mesh can communicate to any service in our service mesh. Let's fix that. In this case, we're gonna implement a very specific policy. We will be very explicit about what service will allow to talk what service. As example here, we do have an example policy that called allow front to back policy that allows communicate all the services that mark as the backend to services that marked as database, as well as a tag, but also can specify a fully qualified service name in order to put this match. As you can see at this field kuma.io/service where we can define our service backend can communicate with. In our case, our Apollo GraphQL server and our blog engine will have backend role, and database will have a role of database. And our natural language processor service will have match by its fully qualified name. As you can see here, this random PSSQL client here. We also have explicit policy about gateway, so our gateway can talk to our front-end service. Our Kong gateway can communicate to front-end. And in order to make all nice conk mesh observability tools to work, we also allowing all this communication for metrics components. So our services will be able to report metrics back to Prometheus and Grafana. Let's apply this fine-grained permission. And now we have all these new traffic permissions here. And our application will continue to work and we still be able to get list of blogs or create new blog posts. Let's try our PS SQL client. As you can see here, PS SQL client cannot communicate to our database anymore, which is nice because we disable this communication and it can't connect this. And it appears like connection to database was broken, which is exactly what we're trying to achieve here. Simply by adding this pod to the same network, to the same mesh that we're running, is not enough anymore. We are very explicit about our communication. Let's go a little bit even more specific for certain operations if we need to implement those. Next, we want to show you different type of policy that is available to you. That's called OPA policy, open policy, agent policy. This allows you to create a very specific rules that will feed into your some of the organizational structure. Maybe you have very specific requirements for services, very specific requirement from InfoSec team, etc. As you can see on this custom resource, we do have this OPA policy kind. It uses same default mesh. We're going to be applying this policy to the same mesh that we used on the previous example. And what you can see here, we defining here policy that essentially allows only HTTP GET methods, essentially makes the system read-only. And when we apply this policy, we lock down our system, make it read-only. So now we cannot submit new blog posts. We still can read the data, but now we cannot submit this. And now we have the message is the communication is forbidden. That's the power of open agent policy. Let's break this down, what you just saw here. We applied mTLS in order to create a secure communication between every node in the mesh. We disconnected this random Postgres client from our mesh. We applied very specific rules for each service. And with this, we're done. And if you want to learn more, go to conghu.com/solution/zero-trust-security. Don't forget to check other demos for our virtual demo floor to learn more about cloud-native connectivity, service mesh, and Kong. As for now, have a nice day.